Very happy news. Our judges have spoken, and we have three winners for our no-code AppGyver contest. Here are the winners in no particular order. Mateus Branco, who built the scuba diving operators management system. Everybody loved the sleek look and feel and thought it was well-designed from its UI logic and database. Then there's Ah Cheng Yang, who built the all-in-one travel app. It has currency conversion, travel information, calendar, and even, what I really liked, an SAP conversational chatbot. And finally, Patricia Rossi, who built that plant application that lets you catalog and identify plants that you see as you take a beautiful stroll in the countryside. All three winners will get a no-code hoodie and also a special badge in the SAP community. Everyone who entered will see a different badge in their profile in the SAP community. Congratulations to everyone who entered, especially the three winners.
We covered the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP, release 6.0 in last week's SAP Developer News episode, but we thought it was worth mentioning a few more release 6.0 related features this week. First, Kyma, the SAP managed offering for Kubernetes, is now an officially supported platform for deployment and runtime of CAP applications and services. We mentioned some deployment features in this area last week, but there are also important runtime features, one of which is the use of an open standard for getting access to and binding with credentials for external services, a bit like the VCAP services environment variable in the Cloud Foundry environment. This open standard is servicebindings.io, a community-led effort to standardize how services are bound to Kubernetes workloads. You can read more about the runtime features of Kubernetes.io and more, and the official support for Kyma in the two blog posts from Uwe Klinger. One more feature that caught our eye in the CAP release 6.0 is the now official support and recognition on GitHub for the CAP CDS language. This means, amongst other things, that we get syntax highlighting for CAP CDS on github.com, which is great, and we also see that CAP CDS features in the language stats for any given repo. Check out this feature and all the rest of the release 6.0 features in the usual place in the CAPI documentation.
Are you planning to attend the Mastering SAP conference in Melbourne, Australia? It's taking place on July 20th through the 22nd. If so, we have a special free treat for you on July 20th as part of that event. We will be hosting the latest instance of the ABAP CodeJam, giving you hands-on experience with the SAP Business Technology Platform ABAP environment and the ABAP RESTful Application Programming Model. This will be a 4 hours of developer networking and hands-on coding exercises. If you wish to attend, please RSVP in the SAP Community Events page and be sure to review the technical prerequisites so that we can maximize our time together the day of the event. I'm looking forward to seeing everyone in person at this exciting event.
Hi everyone. Here are some new releases for the UI5 Web Component Libraries. OpenUI5 just put out version 1.104.0. The link control has now a new API to allow the changing of the role to button. There have also been updates to the placeholders for table and object cards, so these features can now be much more detailed. The card widget as a whole has had multiple new experimental features added in this release as well. For all the UI5 web components for React fans, a new version 0.26.0 has just been released. This includes added support for version 1.5.0 of the UI5 web components, bug fixes, removal of depreciated entry points, such as how the components are imported into your code, removal of the last of the Internet Explorer 11 support, a version bump for the minimum supported version of React, and an overhaul of the analytical card header component, which is part of my favorite component, the analytical table. So be sure to check that out. This is not all of these new releases contain, so be sure to check out the links below for more details on the latest releases from both of these component libraries. Happy coding!
Hola, SAP developers. I'm here to share with you a great blog post series published by Raja related to the fundamentals of security in SAP BTP. The blog post series provides a great explanation of basic security concepts in SAP BTP. The blog posts include diagrams which help understanding these basic concepts. For example, what is an identity provider? What's the identity authentication service? What problem does the user account and authentication service solve? And what is the purpose of the application router? Once you understand the basic concepts, Roger explains step by step how you can implement authentication in a Node.js application that you will end up deploying to SAP BTP. Make sure to follow Raja's blog post series as he dives deeper in the fundamentals of security in SAP BTP.